Each of us has a relationship with the Canada Revenue Agency. It's a yearly relationship that's renewed when we do our annual tax return. Now, some of us also have a business relationship with the CRA. And because the CRA knows how important it is for both individuals and business owners to be able to access current information and tools, the CRA has developed a series of online tools that give us access to what we need regarding our taxes. Now, we've looked at these tools in past episodes, but we felt it was important to revisit this topic again. Many of us choose to let others take care of our tax affairs. I'm talking, of course, about accounting professionals, CAs, CGAs, bookkeepers. Now, if we've got a business, we may also have an accounting department or an outside firm that does all of our accounting. But regardless whether you're an individual or a business owner, we need to make sure that the people who work for us are able to do their job properly. And doing their job properly is all about having access to all of the tools, information, and services that the CRA provides. The CRA has a service called Represent a Client. Accountants and bookkeepers, or your employees, anybody taking care of your tax affairs, can use Represent a Client to access tax information online, your tax information. Representatives or businesses register with the Represent a Client service and then give their rep ID or business number to their clients, who in turn authorize them. Now they're able to access all of your tax information online. So Represent a Client gives your authorized accounting staff or representatives access to your account information and allows them to communicate directly with the CRA on your behalf. And access to all this information is a real bonus, because now they have real control over your relationship with the CRA. Now, the biggest consideration for a service like this is security, and Represent a Client is secure. It gives your representatives secure access by using the Government of Canada ePass and CRA authentication. Your representative is going to need an ePass to use the system, but it only takes them a few minutes to sign up for an ePass. So don't worry. The information on how to apply is all on the Government of Canada website. So let's take a look. Why don't we get started? I'm here in the Represent a Client main menu, and this is really a three-step process to registering. First of all, you need to register yourself, then you need to be authorized by your client, and then you need to access the account. So we're working here as though we are an accountant or an accounting firm or a representative who's going to go and do some tax work on behalf of one of our clients. So we start by registering ourselves as a representative, and we go through and fill in all the information here that the CRA asks for as far as registering and authorizing ourselves online. Once you go through that process, you will be issued this, which is your rep ID number. The rep ID is the code that you give back to your clients or employer so that they can authorize you to work on their behalf. Once you've done that, once you're registered, your clients authorize you either online, or they can also do it using paper forms, the T1013 or the RC59. Now, those can be downloaded from the CRA website. And the forms are also available in commercial tax preparation software packages used by most tax professionals. But the paper forms need to be mailed to the CRA, and some delays can occur before these forms are data captured by the CRA. However, if you get authorized online, it's instantaneous. So encourage your clients to do it online. Let's return now to the main menu, and let's show you how you actually end up using the service if you are a representative. So we're going to log on as an individual into our account, and then you enter each of your different clients' social insurance numbers, and you can start to work on their account. The beauty of this is, once you've logged on and registered, you don't have to log out in order to work for a different client. You can go into a single client screen like we have here, and this is one of the clients that this representative would work on. Once you've done the different details you need here, you can click on Transact on behalf of another client, and that takes us back in and allows us to enter another client's information. So we don't have to log on and log out as we're going through our daily task. And a lot of representatives are going to have multiple clients that they work for. Let me go back to the main menu one more time and show you some of the maintenance tools that are available to you. If we go into the maintenance area, we can see a list of all of the different representatives and all of the different accounts that work for this particular firm. So I can go into client list and transactions here, and I can see all of the different taxpayers who have authorized this particular business to work on their behalf. And there's a list of those different clients. I can also here go in and I can check on the transactions performed on individual accounts. And this gives me a list of all of the different communications and transactions performed with the CRA by this representative firm on behalf of this individual client. So all this information is contained in one place. And by the way, this service is available year-round, 21 hours a day, and 20 hours on Sunday. That's because they need 4 hours of sleep on Sundays. Actually, it's because they take the site down for a few hours every day for backup and maintenance. If you use professionals for any of your accounting, business, or personal work, represent a client is something that they need to use. It just makes sense. Represent a client will make your life easier as both a taxpayer or a boss, and it'll make your employees' or representatives' jobs easier as well. Our government's made a huge commitment to e-services, and when you choose to use them, everything runs better and more smoothly. Represent a client is a great example of that.